Okay, so how do you solve math equations? I'm Jimmy, and I'm here to help you start the process of solving math equations by starting out with a very basic example. Now, I have to tell you at the beginning of the math equation what variable, what letter to solve for. Now, when they tell you what letter to solve for, that means they want you to get the letter by itself. So here's an example to help get you started in that process. 7x minus 10 is equal to 11. Now, there's two operations at work here. That multiplication, 7 is multiplied with the x, and they're subtracting 10. And now most folks, having been familiar with the order of operations, they'll think, okay, well, multiplication comes before subtraction, right? Well, unfortunately, what you have to think about is, in solving equations, if they ask you to solve for a particular variable, they want you to get that by itself. So what you want to do is get the terms that have nothing to do, in this case, x, to the other side. If you want to solve for x, you need to move the non-x terms over. Take this minus 10, for example. That has nothing to do with x. Go ahead and move it over. And as you know with solving equations, you have to perform the opposite operation. Because this is being subtracted by 10, you add 10, but you have to balance it on the other side, so you have to add 10 as well. So you have 7x equals to 21. Now you look at the other operation. 7 is multiplied with the x, so you have to do the opposite. Divide both sides by 7. You have to maintain the balance when it comes to solving an equation. Now, 7 divided by 7, that's 1, so you're left with x. 21 divided by 7 is 3, and that's how you solve an equation. I'm Jimmy, and I just gave you an example on how to do that.